Nutrafol is a very popular hair growth supplement, but is it safe? Let me show you a report on Nutrafol that may give some people some pause for concern. I'll give you my thoughts on this research, and then I also want to turn my attention to the ingredients in Nutrafol and give you my thoughts on that to hopefully save you some money. So here's a report I'm referring to, Nutrafol's Hair Gains and Liver Strains. This is a case report. It's not a clinical trial, but it's essentially a doctor writing up what happened. We have a 26-year-old woman, and she's having some medical complaints. She goes to the hospital. They run some tests, and they find that her liver enzymes are elevated, her bilirubin is elevated, and her liver is inflamed as well. After some questioning, she discloses that on the recommendation of her dermatologist, 5 months prior to all these medical issues, she started taking the Nutrafol hair growth supplement. She also discloses that she's drinking Mulan leaf tea, but I looked into that and didn't see any issues relating to this Mulan tea and liver problems, which is another reason why the doctors are likely linking Nutrafol to her liver issues. Another reason for this is once she stopped taking Nutrafol, her liver enzymes, etc., started to get better. In the report, the doctors do call out that Nutrafol does contain some ingredients, which there have been some reports of these ingredients being linked to liver problems, which again is another reason why they're putting the onus here on Nutrafol. Now, this appears to be the only case of Nutrafol-induced liver problems out there, at least that's the only one that I found, so that is a good thing. But let's turn our attention to the ingredients in Nutrafol. And as you can see here, this is the supplement facts label for Nutrafol. There is a lot of ingredients in Nutrafol. Let me go through just a few of them here. There's a lot of beta-carotene in Nutrafol. I don't personally think the beta carotene plays any role in hair growth, so I would discount that. I also see that it has some biotin. Biotin is really, really popular in the hair growth arena. I see it in a lot of hair growth supplements. I will link to my previous video on the biotin hair growth research so you can see the results for yourself on that. So it contains some iodine and some selenium as well. Both iodine and selenium says to me they're putting these ingredients in Nutrafol to kind of hedge their bets against people who may experience hair loss due to hypothyroidism. But some of the ingredients that were highlighted in this report were found in the Synergen Complex and the Nutrafol Complex. These are both proprietary blends that are specific to Nutrafol itself. Now, looking at these proprietary blends, the thing that jumps out at me is all of the ingredients in the Synergen Complex only add up to 1.68 grams. That's not a lot. And all of the ingredients in the Nutrafol proprietary blend only amount to 530 milligrams. Again, that's not a lot. And when you look at proprietary blends, companies have to list them in the order of most abundant to the least abundant. So we look at the Synergen Complex, collagen makes up most of this 1.68 grams. And in the Nutrafol blend, cysteine makes up most of that 530 milligram blend. Now, while neither of these blends adds up to a lot, one thing that I wonder about is it possible that all the ingredients in this product added up in this unique individual to produce these liver problems? And this is also something to keep in the back of your mind when you deal with any multi-ingredient dietary supplement. We may not have information on how all of the ingredients act together. In the report, it is mentioned that she started taking Nutrafol on the recommendation of her dermatologist. I have found that dermatologists appear to love Nutrafol, and I always wondered about that. I'll link to a previous video I did on Nutrafol so you can see some of the research. That said, if you've gone shopping for Nutrafol, you've found that it's probably pretty expensive. So let me try to save you a little bit of money here. When I look at the ingredients in Nutrafol, one ingredient stands out to me the most, and that is sal pimento. There is research on sal pimento potentially helping hair growth, and that's why I tend to see sal pimento in an awful lot of hair growth supplements. Unfortunately, we're probably never going to see research on Nutrafol versus sal pimento or any other hair growth supplement itself. But if you're thinking about a hair growth solution and you're on the fence about Nutrafol, why not just try sal pimento for yourself and see if it works for you? And if you've been following my channel for any length of time, you know I have reviewed an awful lot of hair growth supplements and the research on them, and I'm going to link to all of them below this video so you can see that proof too. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video with your friends, and I'll see you next time real soon.